मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, वेलकम बैक टू ई लर्निंग क्लासेस ऑफ पी एन अमरसी हाई स्कूल। होप यू ऑल आर सेफ। सो चिल्ड्रेन, लेट्स बिगिन आर चैप्टर नंबर 6, एक्सपर्ट डिटेक्टिव्स। बिफोर वी स्टार्ट द चैप्टर, लेट मी गिव यू सम नॉलेज अबाउट द ऑथर। शी इज शारदा द्विवेदी। दिस पार्ट इज टेकन फ्रॉम द ब्रोकन फ्लूट। शी वॉज एन इंडियन ऑथर, हिस्टोरियन एंड रिसर्चर। She wrote several books on the history and culture of both India and Mumbai. She was on the panel on the Mumbai Heritage Conservation Committee. Among her most famous work was Bombay, the Cities Within. She was born in 1942. She died on 6th February 2012 in Mumbai. This story is about a brother and a sister. Nishad is a boy and Maya is his sister. Nishad is a boy of 7 years old, and he is also called 7 because of his name means the 7th note on the musical scale. Both are very curious about their neighbor Mr. Nath. They think that Mr. Nath is a crook, means he is a criminal. His mother is a doctor and she knows Mr. Nath as a patient. She says he is very polite man. Let's read part 1 of the story, Expert Detectives. As we walked back towards the clinic, Seven said, "He doesn't look anything like a monster." Maya, "But did you see how thin he is? Maybe he's very poor and can't afford to eat." "He can't be poor if he's a crook on the run," I told him. "He's probably got millions of rupees stashed away somewhere in that room." "Do you really think he's a criminal, Maya?" "He doesn't look like one." Nishad looked doubtful. "Of course he is one, Seven," I said. "And he certainly isn't starving. Mr. Mehta told us that Ramesh brings his meal up from the restaurant downstairs." Children here, both Nishad and Maya are discussing about Mr. Nath. Maya thinks he is a crook and criminal, but Nishad doesn't agree with her. Says that he has no food and he is poor. He could not eat much food. That's why he is so thin. Maya says he is not poor and he eats enough. He is not starving. Ramesh brings his meal from downstairs. There is a restaurant. But Maya, Mr. Mehta told us he doesn't work anywhere. So how can he possibly have money to pay for food? Nishad said. Now children, here Nishad is confused that he is not going anywhere for the work. How can he pay for that food? "Exactly," I exclaimed. "He must have lots of money hidden somewhere, maybe in the trunk in his room. It's probably full of silver and gold and jewel and..." "What rubbish," Nishad interrupted. "I know I'm right, stupid," I told him. "By the way, Seven, did you see his cards?" "I couldn't. It was too dark, but I bet he got them during the shootout with the police or something." "Mummy told us quite clearly they were burn scars," Nishad said firmly. And here we comes to know that there are scar marks on his face. As mother is a doctor, she told them that they are burn marks and Mr. Nath is coming for his treatment also. But this Maya doesn't understand this thing and she is not agreeing that he is a quite good person, but she said he is a crook and he got scars during the shootout with the police. Perhaps the police had to set his house on fire to force him out, I suggested. Seven looked unsure. On the Monday following Mama's birthday, Seven went alone with her to the clinic at Girgaon. As I was spending the evening with a school friend, when they returned, Nisa told me he had been to see Mr. Nath and I felt most annoyed that I hadn't been there. Seven had been quite upset about Mr. Nath's gaunt appearance and was sure that he was starving. He told me that he had knocked loudly on Mr. Nath's door that evening and said, "Open the door quickly, Mr. Nath." The man opened it and asked him, "Lost another marble?" And here, when Nishad went to his mother's clinic one day, he saw Mr. Nath there. He said to his sister that there was Mr. Nath. Maya is very annoyed as she too wanted to see Mr. Nath. Seven added that Mr. Nath is a quite good fellow because when he went to his house and knocked the door quickly, Mr. Nath opened the door and he asked him, "Did you lost your another marble?" "He had obviously recognized my brother." "No," said Nishad. He had taken the man's hand in his own and thrust a bar of chocolate into it. "Did you get a chance to peek into the trunk, Seven?" I asked. Nishad looked disappointed. "He didn't even ask me in," he said. Then he smiled. "But I did find out something, Maya. I went down to the restaurant where Ramesh works and talked to him." "Good for you, Mr. Detective," I said, patting him on the back. "I hope you question him properly." Seven looked pleased. "Ramesh told me that he takes 2 meals for Mr. Nath every morning and evening and 2 cups of tea. One in the morning and one in the afternoon." Children, in this paragraph we come to know that they got some more information about Mr. Nath, as Ramesh is bringing 2 meals at the day and 2 cups of tea in the morning and in the afternoon. Ramesh says he is not very particular about what he eats. It's always the same food. 2 chapatis, some dal and a vegetable. Mr. Nath pays cash and tips well. "Ramesh told me something very strange, Maya," Seven added. "Almost every Sunday he carries 2 lunches to Mr. Nath's room, and the same man is with him each time. He's tall, fair, stout, and wears spectacles. Ramesh says his visitor talks a lot, unlike Mr. Nath, who hardly speaks." Means he's not starving, he's eating food in the morning and at afternoon also, and he's paying cash to Ramesh and paying well tip too. There is a visitor every Sunday to him. He is fair, tall, and Ramesh brings 2 lunches for them. And he added that his visitor is very talkative. Unlike Mr. Nath, he speaks hardly. "Well done, Nishad," I told him. "Now that we have made some progress with our inquiries, we'll have to sort out all the facts like expert detectives so that we can trap the crook." Now children, here they are still thinking that Mr. Nath is a crook, and they sort out all the inquiries about him. "How do you go on, Maya?" Seven sighed. "How can you possibly imagine he's a crook? He looks so ordinary." So children, here Nishad doesn't agree with his sister, and he's saying, "How can you imagine that he is a crook? He is so ordinary and normal person." Maya replied, "Criminals can look quite ordinary, smarty," I retorted. "Did you see the picture of the Hyderabadi housebreaker in the paper yesterday? He looked like any man on the street." Nishad looked doubtful. The monsoons broke the next day. Dark clouds accompanied by blinding flashes of lightning and roaring rolls of thunder burst with all their fury, flooding the streets with the heavy downpour. School was to have reopened after the summer holidays, but no traffic could move through the flooded roads, and there was an unexpected holiday. I thought I would spend the time usefully. I sat at my desk in our bedroom with the sheet of paper before me. Children, here there was unexpected holiday just because of the monsoon and heavy rainfall. Maya got the chance to make the list and sort out the things about Mr. Nath, and she got the paper in front of her and started writing something. So children, we keep the explanation till here only. I'll come with the second part of the story in the next video. Till then, stay safe. Thank you and have a nice day.